So in one case we are getting higher strength near the parting line, in one case we are getting higher strength away from the parting line. So what if we want, density. So what if we want uniform density? What will you do? If you want uniform density, what will you do? Jolt plus squeeze. Very good, Danish. Hence, the third one is jolting and squeezing. This is used to get uniform strength throughout. In jolting and squeezing, the jolting is always performed first. Okay. Why? Because if you perform squeezing first and then you go for jolting, then because of the impact load, the sands will get disturbed. Hence, we always go for jolting first, and after jolting, we apply the squeezing. Kumar Vishesh is asking density. Mostly we talk about density, Vishesh, but again, the density and the strength will be related to each other. Higher density will mean higher strength. Higher density will mean better packing and hence better strength. But even then, the density will be more appropriate. I have told density at all points, right? In the dictation, I have told density. Always perform jolting first and then go for squeezing. Okay. So this is jolting and squeezing. So even with jolting and squeezing, you will get uniform strength up to a certain height only. Beyond that height, if you go, again you will get non-uniform strength. The middle portion will become weak. Okay. For example, generally, we'll go for jolting and squeezing up to 200 mm height of the mold. For example, that is 200 mm means 20 cm height of the mold. Up to that height, we'll get uniform density. If you go for higher height, you won't get uniform density. The middle portion will have lesser density. So if you want to get uniform strength throughout, whatever be the height. For example, here we can write up to 200 mm mold height. We go for something called as, in all the previous cases, you might have realized that we are getting higher strength in the portion in which we were applying the ramming force. Whichever portion we are applying the ramming force, in that portion we are getting the higher density. Hence, to get uniform density throughout, what should we do? Here, what we do is, we will use a machine, and the function of that machine will be to throw sand particles inside the flask. Here, the sand particle will be falling down with high velocity. And because it is falling down with high density, with high velocity, localized ramming will be taking place. At each point, ramming is taking place. And since the ramming is taking place at each point, we'll get uniform density throughout. Hence, in sand slinging, what we are doing is, a machine throws sand particles into the flask. Localized ramming takes place, hence we get uniform density throughout. So these are the methods of mold making. These are the methods of mold making. So these are the methods of mold making. Next is gating system. Next is the gating system. So next topic name is gating system. So you all might be feeling that very theoretical portions are going on, right? Like beginning of the casting is quite theoretical. So after the gating system, we'll start getting numerical portions. Okay, in gating system, we'll get numerical portions. Then we'll have a topic by the name of solidification. Then we'll get the numerical portions. And then we'll have the topic by the name of riser design. Then again, we'll get the numerical portion. Okay, so please bear with me. So let us start with the gating system. Okay, so as I told you in the beginning of the class, that once we have made the cavity, we need to make some passages so that the molten metal can flow into the cavity. So all these passages are the part of gating system. All these passages that we have are the part of the gating system. So let's have a look at the diagram. Let's suppose this is a flask. This is our cavity. And these are the passages that we have made for the flow of molten metal. Around all this, we have the molding sand. But more will be the clarity, right? Okay, you people tell me, what is the name of which portion? What is the name of this flask? Cope. Very good. This flask? Drag. This is the cavity. And what is the name of this line? Parting line. Very good. Okay. So let's come back to the gating system. In the videos we saw one more hole, right? That hole is nothing but the riser. So how does the molten metal flow is, we'll pour it from here. It will start filling the cavity. After filling the cavity, start filling the riser. The top funnel portion that you can see, is called as the pouring basin. It acts as a reservoir for the molten metal. That is, whatever molten metal you are going to use, first you are going to pour it inside the pouring basin, and from the pouring basin it will travel to all the passages. Then we have this vertical portion. The name of this vertical portion is sprue. Okay. Then we have this horizontal section. The name of this horizontal section is runner. And then we have the point at which the molten metal is entering the cavity. This is called as the gate or ingate. Okay. And then this portion is the riser. So this is the gating system. Please draw this diagram. If you have made the diagram, please reply as yes or done. Okay, guys. So first write down pouring basin. It acts as a reservoir of molten metal. First one is a pouring basin. Second one is the sprue. Sprue is the connecting passage between the pouring basin and the runner. Right? So sprue is the connecting passage. You can see here that the sprue is tapered section. It is tapered to avoid aspiration. So what is aspiration is, what happens is, sometimes along the passage, if the flow is not full, that is the passage is not completely filled with the molten metal, and there is some air, then that air will attract more gases or more air from the molding sand. It will allow the more air from the molding sand to enter the passage. Okay. This entering of air into the molten metal is called as aspiration. Okay. We'll cover this topic aspiration in depth. From aspiration numericals have come. Okay. We'll cover this topic in depth. It is tapered to avoid aspiration. Okay, now let's come to the fluid mechanics. In fluid mechanics, how is the velocity related to the head of the molten metal? Yeah, Bernoulli's, from that, the height, we get velocity is root 2gh. Very good. Velocity is equal to root 2gh. This h is the potential head of the fluid. Right? So, this potential head is dependent upon what? This potential head is dependent upon the height of the sprue. So, overall, we can say the height of the sprue influences the velocity of the molten metal. The height of the sprue influences the velocity of the molten metal. And let's come to the runner portion. What is the use of the runner? The third section is the runner section. Okay. Let's say we are not using the runner. We are simply pouring the molten metal directly inside the gate or ingate. Okay. And suppose this is a cavity, and instead of using the runner, we are pouring the molten metal directly inside the cavity. Okay. So from here the molten metal will come and will strike this portion. Because of this, some impact load is acting on this portion, and because of the impact load, some sand will get eroded here. Some sand erosion will take place. And because of the sand erosion, some sand will get trapped inside the casting. Okay, it will reduce the strength of the casting. And this is a defect called as sand inclusion. Hence, it is not recommended. Therefore, what we do is, we'll take a horizontal passage so that the molten metal is entering this portion. And when it enters this portion, the sand erosion will take place here. And in this location, we'll keep something for filtering the sand. Okay. So therefore, the sand will not get trapped inside the casting. It will not become a part of the casting. And hence, no sand inclusion will take place. Okay. So, the purpose of runner is a connecting passage between the sprue and the gate, used to minimize the sand erosion. Then we have the ingate. Fourth one is the ingate. It is the last point from where the molten metal enters the cavity. Okay. And then we have the riser. Then we have the riser. Again, riser is also a reservoir. Riser is also a reservoir for the molten metal. Okay, but its purpose is to feed the molten metal as it is getting shrunk. As the molten metal is shrinking, the riser feeds more molten metal. Okay, so it is a reservoir to compensate. It is a reservoir to compensate. Reservoir to compensate for the liquid and solidification shrinkages. It is a reservoir to compensate for the liquid and solidification shrinkages taking place. How runner reduces the sand erosion? See, Saurav, if you don't use the runner, the molten metal will directly be entering from the top. Okay, so from the top when it is entering, it will flow very rapidly and it will fall in this portion. And it will fall with high impact energy. Because of that sand erosion will take place. Now, if you look here, a controlled flow of the molten metal is taking place. Hence, the impact energy, very small impact energy will be taking place. Very small impact load will be acting here. And therefore, there will be very less sand erosion at this point. Because there is controlled flow. If the molten metal were entering from this point, in this much portion, there is no control over the flow of the molten metal. It will simply attain a high velocity and it will fall here. Because of that, high impact load will act. Only turbulence problem gets sorted out because of what? Acha, clear? The five elements that we have seen. What are the five elements? The pouring basin, sprue, runner, ingate, and the riser. These are the main five elements of the gating system. Along with this, we have something called as accessories of the gating system. So what do you understand by accessories? For example, as humans, we wear a watch, we wear a belt, we wear specs. These are all called as accessories. These are just used to improve our efficiency. They are not very, very necessary. Even if I'm not wearing the watch, it will be okay. But if I'm wearing the watch, it will improve my efficiency. If I'm not wearing a belt, it is okay. But wearing a belt improves my efficiency. I don't have to lift my pant again and again. Right? It is saving time for me. Similarly, we use something called as accessories in the gating system also. Without also, we can make the gating system, but they are used to improve the efficiency of the gating system. So let us see what are the accessories in a gating system. We use a filter made up of ceramic. In the bottom of the pouring basin, we use a filter made up of ceramic that is called as the strainer. Its purpose is to filter out the impurities. Okay. Then this portion. In this portion, we have a concern that because of the falling of the molten metal, some sand erosion may take place. Okay. So, to avoid sand erosion, they simply remove the sand and they put a ceramic material. This is called as, here we have something called as the skim bob. This one is called as skim bob. So what is the purpose of skim bob? Let's suppose the molten metal is flowing from here. Now in the molten metal there are some impurities. Splash core is also made of ceramic. Okay. Here we have skim bob. Let's suppose the molten metal is having some impurities. This impurities will be having some density other than the density of the molten metal. The density of impurities will be different from the density of molten metal. So let's say in this portion some low density impurity is there. and in this portion some high density impurity is there. So what will happen is this impurities will get stuck here. This impurities will get stuck here. Okay. This impurities will get stuck here and the molten metal will simply flow from between the impurities. The molten metal will simply flow from the between the impurities. So the purpose of the scheme bob is to separate low density and high density impurities. The purpose of the scheme bob is to separate low density and high density impurities. This is low density. How these three provided? At the time of making only, for example here, where we know that the runner will be made. For example, in the parting line, we insert the splash core, After making the pouring basin, we'll insert the filter, made up of ceramic. And for scheme bob, again, we can use either the pattern, we can make the scheme bob portion in the pattern itself. And later we can remove the pattern and the scheme bob will be made in the passage. Okay, Saurav. So please make this diagram. How is this scheme bob useful? Everyone who has not understood scheme bob, please look here. See, the molten metal is flowing. In the molten metal, there are some impurities. Low density impurities will keep floating on the top. High density impurities will keep floating in the bottom portion. Okay. Then, here, the low density impurities will get stuck at this portion. The high density impurities will get stuck at this corner, and sorry, the low density impurities will get stuck at this corner, and high density impurities will get stuck at this corner, and the molten metal will simply flow through the between. So, vicious doubt is the impurities will not go in, Some portion of the impurity may go in, but majority will get stuck in the corner. Okay, so purpose of the strainer, first one is. The strainer is made up of ceramic. Purpose is to separate impurities. Then we have splash core. Second one is the splash core. Again it is made up of ceramic. And its purpose is to minimize sand erosion. And the third one was scheme bob. Its purpose is to separate low density and high density impurities. Some isometric image of the splash core. See, here, when the molten metal is coming here, there are chances that because of the impact load, some sand erosion may take place. So, to avoid sand erosion, we are simply removing the sand, and instead of the sand, we are keeping a ceramic material. The ceramic material will not easily break off under the impact load. It will be having good strength. Okay, hence sand erosion will not be there. Since there is no sand here, there will be no sand erosion. Okay, Sunil. Let us see the characteristics of gating system. What are the characteristics a gating system should have? First of all, let's talk about the pouring time. So from the name pouring time, you can understand that the pouring time is a time required for complete filling of the cavity. Now please tell me, how should be the pouring time? Should it be high or should it be low? Solidification does not happen. Okay guys, the pouring time is the time required for complete filling of the cavity. It should be as low as possible. So that no solidification takes place before complete filling of the cavity. For example, this was the passage. Right? If the pouring time is very, very high, chances are that the molten metal has not completely filled the cavity, and before that itself, some portion of the gating system gets solidified. Some part of the gating system gets solidified. If some part of the gating system is getting solidified, it will not allow the flow of the molten metal. It will not allow the flow of the molten metal. Hence, we try to keep the pouring time as low as possible so that the complete cavity gets filled as fast as possible without any solidification in the gating system. Okay. It should be as low as possible. No part solidifies before complete filling. So that no part solidifies before complete filling of cavity. Second is velocity. How should be the flow velocity? Should it be high? Should it be low? The right answer is the velocity should be high. When the velocity of flow of the molten metal is high, then only the pouring time will be low. When the velocity of molten metal is high, then only the pouring time will be low. But how high should it be? Should it be as high as possible? Sunil and Anshu, should it be as high as possible? Safe answer, Kaushik, optimal. Anshu is saying yes. No. Guys, velocity should be as high as possible, but within laminar zone. If it becomes higher than the velocity in laminar zone, it will become turbulent. The flow will become turbulent. And when the flow becomes turbulent, there are more chances of air particles getting trapped inside the flow. If the air particle gets trapped inside the flow, it will become a part of the casting. The air will become a part of the casting and it will reduce the strength of the casting. Understood? Air getting trapped. Okay. Third point is, avoid sand erosion. Fourth point is, no aspiration should take place. The flow should be full. What is the meaning of flow should be full? It means the flow should not take place like this. That is, the entire sprue should be filled with the molten metal. Okay, it should not be like some portion is molten metal, some portion is air. The flow should be full, or we can say partial flow is not allowed. Partial flow of molten metal is not allowed. Okay, so these are the characteristics of gating system. Then we have the types of the gating system. So let's start with the types of the gating system. Before starting with type of the gating system, there is something called as gating ratio. What is a gating ratio? Why air will get trapped if turbulent? See, laminar flow is like a continuous flow. A proper flow of molten metal will be there. In turbulent flow, it is not like this. Turbulent flow flows like this, right? So because of this, there will be chances of air getting trapped. Then we have something called as gating ratio. It is a ratio. So aspiration I have already explained one time. Like basic, what is aspiration, that I have explained. Aspiration will be covered in depth, like after one or two topics. Okay, don't worry. If you have not understood aspiration, it will be covered more in depth. Okay. So gating ratio is the ratio of three areas. AS, AR, AI. In the gating system, what is starting by the name S? Is it sprue? Then we have, after sprue, the molten metal enters which portion? It enters runner. After runner, it enters which portion? Ingate. Okay. So AS AR AI is a ratio of, it is a ratio of cross section area of sprue to the cross section area of run end to the cross section area of ingate. It is the ratio of cross section area of sprue to the cross section area of runner to the cross section area of ingate. So let's see the types of gating system. By using gating ratio, what we will have is, even if you know one area, if you know any one of this area, and if you know the ratio, you can calculate all other areas, right? So that is the purpose of the gating ratio. In a way, it is denoting, it is a way of denoting all the areas. The gating system can be classified on two ways. It can be classified on the two ways. One is on the basis of pressure, and other one is on the location of the gate. Okay. So there are two ways of classifying a types of gating system. One is based on pressure. Based on pressure, it can be classified as pressurized and non-pressurized. And the second one is based on the location of the gate. Based on location of the gate, it can be classified as top gating system, bottom gating system, then parting gating system. Top gating system, GS means gating system, it is not general studies. Okay, top gating system, bottom gating system, parting gating system, and then step gating system. Then we have the step gating system. Okay, so these are the different gating systems. So let us start with, what do you understand by pressurized and non-pressurized gating system? Before pressurized and non-pressurized, you need to understand what is top, bottom, and parting and step. Because at one place, the step gating system will play a role. Okay, so better let's start with the second classification. So, first we are starting with based on location of gate. So, based on location of gate, the first classification is top gating system. From the name, everything will be clear. Based on location of the gate, we are saying it is top gating system. So what could be the meaning of top gating system? What do you understand from the name top gating system? Enters from the top. The molten metal enters from the top of the cavity. So this is the cavity. The molten metal is entering from the top. So this becomes the top gating system. Okay. Now, let's suppose the cavity is having volume V. I'm using the notation VOL for denoting the volume of the cavity. VOL is equal to volume of cavity. Okay. So let's say I want to calculate the pouring time. So pouring time will be volumetric flow rate. What is the expression for volumetric flow rate? Can anyone tell me what is the expression for volumetric flow rate? Q is what? It is multiplication of two things. Which two things? Area into velocity. Very good. It is volume into area into velocity. Volume upon area into velocity. Okay. So this A we write as AC. AC is nothing but the choke area. V is the velocity. V is the maximum velocity. Okay. AC is called as choke area. V here we are taking as maximum velocity. So what is choke area? Is choke area is minimum of all the three areas. We have taken three areas, right? We have taken sprue, we have taken runner, we have taken ingate. So minimum of sprue, runner and ingate area is called as the choke area. Okay, then we have Vmax. Vmax is the maximum velocity. Vmax is equal to root over of 2gh. Vmax is equal to root over of 2gh. Okay. Vmax is equal to root over of 2gh. So, is anyone having any doubt in this expression? Volume upon AC into Vmax. Okay. I'll tell you the doubt. One doubt students generally have is, sir, we take the velocity at the point where we are considering the area. We take the velocity at the point where we are considering the area. How are you taking one velocity? How are you taking one area? How are you taking one velocity and how are you taking one area? Saurav is asking, what is AC? Saurav, AC is called as choke area. AC is called as choke area. It is minimum of sprue, area of runner, area of ingate. Area of sprue, area of runner, area of ingate. Okay. So I was saying, what is the doubt that students generally have? Students generally have the doubt, sir, you have taken velocity at one point, you have taken AC, that is area at one point. It is not necessary that the choke area will have root 2gh velocity. Root 2gh velocity will be at this point. It is not necessary that AC will have that velocity. Right? So, my explanation for that is, here we are trying to calculate the worst possible pouring time. Here we are trying to calculate the worst possible pouring time. Small areas has maximum velocity. That's why Danish is saying, sir, you have taken minimum area. And the minimum area will obviously have maximum velocity. Danish is saying right. What Danish is saying is absolutely correct. But Danish, here Vmax is just the Vmax name. If you go by the notation, Vmax is the velocity at this point. Vmax is the velocity at this point. Right? Because it is root 2gh. It is not necessary that Vmax will be the velocity at the choke point. Whatever is the choke point, it is not necessary that Vmax will be the velocity at choke point. Right? So, we consider AC and Vmax for safe design. We consider AC and Vmax for safe design, for factor of safety. In a way, you can say for factor of safety. By using AC and Vmax, we'll get the worst possible pouring time. We'll get the worst possible pouring time. Is pouring time unit second inverse? Okay, Amrita, let's see. No, it will be second only. See, volume is having unit meter cube. It is having unit. AC is having meter square. Vmax is having meter per second. So, meter cube per second. Meter cube will get cancelled. Second will go in the numerator. Right? So, AC is the choke area. It is minimum of sprue, runner and ingate area. Vmax is root 2gh. Here, h is the height up to which molten metal is maintained. The height up to which the molten metal is maintained. Okay. So this is top gating system. Now let's see the bottom gating system, and there I'll explain why this velocity I'm calling as Vmax. Minesh, that's what I tried to explain. By using the minimum area, area is in the denominator. The area is in denominator. So, this fraction will get bigger, will get the maximum possible pouring time. Overall, the pouring time will be less than the value we have calculated. So in a way, whatever pouring time we have calculated is giving us a safe pouring time. It is giving us a safe pouring time, right? If we are taking minimum area, the pouring time will come maximum. If the pouring time is coming maximum, in a way it is giving us the worst possible pouring time. Let us have a look at the bottom gating system. But the discharge remains constant. The height will remain constant. The head of the molten metal we consider as remain considered to be constant. Therefore, the velocity root 2gh will remain constant. That's what I was trying to explain, Danish. The Q is equal to A into V. For that, we always take the area and velocity at the same point. But in this expression, we are taking choke area and we are taking maximum velocity. Okay. Bottom gating system. Here the molten metal will enter from the bottom of the gate. See. So this is bottom gating system. Let's say this is the height of the molten metal that is maintained. When the molten metal is entering from this point, the head difference is H. So initially, when the molten metal is getting filled, we'll get maximum velocity. V max is equal to root 2gh. Okay. But as the molten metal gets filled, you can see that as the molten metal is rising up in the level, the height difference between this point and the molten metal, is reducing. Right? And the velocity depends on the height difference. Velocity between two points depends on the height difference. So, when the molten metal has reached this point, and suppose we are trying to fill the molten metal in this point, what is the height difference now? The height difference is, let's say, HB. So at this point, the velocity will be minimum velocity and it will be equal to root over of 2GHB. Did you understand this point? If you understood, please reply with yes. Since you people are not asking, I am considering that you have understood. So in this case, again, the pouring time will be, volume upon AC, into this time we are taking V average. Because initially when the molten metal is entering, it is having highest velocity, that is V max. And when it is about to fill the cavity, it is getting minimum velocity, V min. So we take average velocity, that is V max plus V mean by 2 is equal to V average. V max plus V mean by 2 is equal to V average. Okay, so pouring time will be volume upon AC into V average, that is V max plus V mean by 2. Understood?